Catastrophic geophysical events, such as floods and dam breaks, have huge effects on people, the environment, and the economy. To better understand the consequences of such events, CSIRO has developed tools and software to model what happens. Computational scientist Mahesh Prakash has been working with collaborators in China to model the collapse of the Geheyan Dam, one of the biggest in the world.
So what we're doing in terms of visualization is we are trying to bring in visual effects, movie-style animation into the scientific world so that the user can actually see exactly what happens when a dam breaks.
The simulations show where the water would go, how fast it would reach important infrastructure, such as power stations, and the extent of inundation in major townships downstream. CSIRO's innovative approach combines static landscape data from a geographic information system with data that changes over time, like fluid flow.
There's actually two reasons why we would want to do a dam break modeling. First one being for disaster management planning, to make sure that there's no critical infrastructure or townships in the way of flooding caused by a dam break. And the second one is for forensic investigation purposes, to make sure that, to actually investigate where people or infrastructure is actually moved following a dam break.
To build the simulation, scientists start with a 3D mesh of the landscape from the geographic information system. They then add texture to the landscape and features like roads and buildings. Finally, they add the water itself.
Fluid flow is actually very difficult to model. We model the water using a technique called smooth particle hydrodynamics, where the water itself is assumed to compose of millions of particles.
Imagine a container filled with hundreds and thousands. If we pour it out, all of those tiny particles together act a bit like water flowing out of the container. Apply that on a large scale, and you've got smoothed particle hydrodynamics being used to model fluid flow for geophysical events.
This modeling is actually very versatile, and it can be used in any areas where you've got fluid flows, such as tsunamis, landslides, flash flooding, storm surges, and so on. And eventually, it's basically going to be helping for disaster management planning in all these cases.